Imagine you're not merely an individual navigating a world of random events and uncontrollable circumstances, but instead, a powerful consciousness deeply woven into the very fabric of the universe. What if, in some mysterious way, the thoughts you hold, the intentions you set, and the dreams you pursue don't just stay within you but ripple out, influencing reality itself? Ancient wisdom has long hinted at such an extraordinary idea, and now, modern thinkers like philosopher David Chalmers are lending credence to these whispers of the soul by exploring consciousness in ways that challenge our very understanding of existence. This vision of reality asks us to look within and see something divine, something capable of creation, buried beneath layers of conditioning, fear, and doubt. When we embrace this possibility, life shifts. We become aware that we are not merely human beings stumbling through a chaotic world, but that we are, in some sense, divine beings, intimately involved in co-creating that world. Join me as we dive into this profound, provocative view, one that offers the potential to transform not only our lives, but the very way we see ourselves and the universe around us. The journey begins with the work of philosopher David Chalmers, whose studies on consciousness bring us to one of the most perplexing questions. Why do we have conscious experiences at all? Chalmers famously calls this the hard problem of consciousness. It's the question not of how the brain works, science can tell us that, but why it feels like anything to be alive. Why do we experience colors, emotions, or sounds as sensations rather than mere information processing? Chalmers' inquiry into the hard problem suggests something radical. Perhaps consciousness is not just an isolated experience occurring in individual minds, but something fundamental to the universe itself. It's a daring idea, yet one that opens the door to seeing ourselves as not just products of nature, but as co-creators of it. Imagine that your consciousness, the awareness inside you right now, is somehow connected to the very laws that govern existence. Such a perspective would mean that you're not only a witness to reality, you're a participant in it, an architect of experience. From Chalmers' perspective, if consciousness is fundamental, then our awareness might have the power to shape reality in ways science is only beginning to glimpse. Ancient texts like the Corpus Hermeticum echo this idea with a simple but provocative statement. Man is a mortal God, and God is an immortal man. In essence, they suggest that within each of us lies a spark of the divine. We are more than just participants in life's unfolding. We are creators. Imagine your thoughts, emotions, and intentions as signals sent out into the universe, each one carrying the potential to influence the world. In quantum physics, a similar principle exists. The act of observation changes the behavior of particles. Just as scientists have seen particles shift under observation, might our own thoughts, beliefs, and feelings shape the world around us? Building on Chalmers' perspective, consider that consciousness is not passive. It's a dynamic, creative force. In practical terms, this means your thoughts, beliefs, and intentions aren't just personal reflections but active participants in the fabric of reality. When we internalize this idea, we begin to see our role in life differently. We are not limited by our external circumstances, but by our own beliefs about them. Ancient wisdom, along with modern studies in consciousness, encourages us to see ourselves as active shapers of reality. As we do, the limitations we once accepted begin to fall away. In this view, every thought and intention becomes a building block of experience. Our inner life, our mental and emotional landscapes, are not mere reactions to the world. They're ingredients in the creative process that shapes it. This means that our journey of personal transformation is also a journey of cosmic importance, as we contribute to the world not just through action, but through thought, belief, and awareness. The most formidable barrier to recognizing our power as creators lies within. Society conditions us to believe we are limited, often by ideas about what is realistic or possible. But what if these limits are not objective truths, but stories we've internalized? Chalmers' exploration into the depths of consciousness suggests that our awareness has no true boundaries. What holds us back, then, is often nothing more than outdated beliefs. If consciousness is indeed a fundamental force, then each belief, each expectation, is part of the code we write into our reality. Limiting beliefs, then, are like restrictive programs running in our minds, shaping what we experience. The good news is that we can rewrite these beliefs. When we release these outdated stories, we make space for the realization of our own boundless potential. Living as a co-creator doesn't mean trying to control every event in our lives. Rather, it's about setting clear intentions that align with our true essence and then letting the universe take the lead. Think of this as a partnership, a cosmic dance. You move with intention, and the universe responds with synchronicities, challenges, and growth opportunities. Chalmers' ideas hint at a universe that is more interconnected than we may realize. If consciousness is part of the universe's fabric, then our intentions aren't just wishes. They are invitations to the universe to bring our inner vision to life. But here's the twist. Co-creation isn't about rigidly controlling the outcome. It's about trusting that the universe's response to our intentions are highest good. Often, this requires patience, allowing space for things to unfold in ways that surprise and elevate us. If consciousness is indeed as fundamental as Chalmers suggests, then spiritual practices like meditation, visualization, and mindfulness become powerful tools, not just for inner peace, but for actively tuning our consciousness to align with universal forces. In meditation, we quiet the mind's chatter, allowing us to connect with deeper levels of awareness. Visualization helps us see ourselves achieving our goals, creating a blueprint that guides our actions. Mindfulness, meanwhile, keeps us rooted in the present, attuned to the signs and opportunities life offers. Through these practices, we begin to see how our awareness connects with the larger whole. In moments of stillness, we can feel the boundaries between ourselves and the universe dissolve, revealing a sense of unity where our individual awareness merges with a greater collective consciousness. This is where our creative potential thrives, a state where we're most in tune with our power to shape life's unfolding. Awakening to our divine nature is not a one-time revelation. It's an ongoing journey, filled with moments of insight, growth, and evolution. As we walk this path, we begin to see each experience as a stepping stone in our journey of self-realization. Every setback and every victory becomes a lesson, a chance to deepen our understanding of who we are. Chalmers' view of consciousness reminds us that our growth is part of a larger, interconnected journey. Every time we overcome a limiting belief or expand our awareness, we contribute to the collective evolution of humanity. Our personal awakening sends ripples through the fabric of consciousness, inspiring others to awaken to their own potential. As we journey through life with a deeper understanding of consciousness, we face a choice. Will we continue to live passively, confined by old beliefs and fears? Or will we embrace our role as co-creators, actively shaping our reality with intention and trust? David Chalmers' work challenges us to see consciousness not as a side effect of physical processes, but as a central player in the story of existence. If consciousness is indeed a fundamental part of reality, then each of us is a force of creation, influencing the world in ways we may not yet fully comprehend. This view of life offers us a powerful perspective. Every thought, every belief, and every intention becomes a tool, a brushstroke on the canvas of existence. When we embrace this role, life transforms into a journey of discovery and creation, a hero's journey in which every experience, every challenge, and every joy serves as an opportunity to step further into our power. You have within you the potential to shape reality, to bring forth possibilities that align with your truest self. It's a journey that requires courage, curiosity, and a willingness to question everything. But as you step into your role as a divine co-creator, you'll find that the universe is not a random backdrop, but a responsive, dynamic force, waiting for you to join the dance. So ask yourself, now that you know your potential, how will you choose to live? The adventure awaits, and the power to shape it lies within you. Will you embrace your role in this cosmic creation, knowing that the choice and the possibilities are truly limitless?